My name is Charlie Croker. A year ago, me and my team pulled off a score that should have set us all up for good. 260 bricks of gold bullion, freshly minted in Indonesia. It was one last big job for all of us in Venice. Or so we thought. There was one thing we hadn't planned on. One of the team, Steve Bandel, decided he wanted it all. In minutes, the heist of our lives vanished. Steve shot our safecracker, John Bridger, an old pro who was my mentor. Probably more than that. I dragged him out of retirement for this one last big score. He could never resist, and it cost him his life. Steve shot him, left us all for dead, and then took it all. Every last damn shiny brick. But you know what? Good things come to those who wait. A year later, I learned that Steve was in L.A. and had used some of that gold to payroll a wall of guards around him. He thought he was home free, but we had one advantage. He also thought we were all dead. Oh no, we were nowhere near dead. And it was time to get that gold back. Time to get some payback for the Italian job. It all began with a meeting. John Bridger was gone. But he had a daughter, Stella. She was as good as he was. And a lot better looking. I called her. Though she blamed me for her father's death, she agreed to meet me. It was going to be a tough sell. Wasn't interested. Not in the gold, but she wanted revenge as much as I did. She agreed to meet the team, all the guys from Venice. No promises from her, but she knew we needed her. The team made their usual good impression. Left Ear, our boom man who never met an explosive he didn't like. The super geek, Lyle, whose skills go way beyond hacking. Oh, and handsome Rob, our premier wheelman who couldn't stop telling Stella how great he was. As for me, she knew all about me. I'd been stealing since I had baby teeth. Revenge is such a powerful motivator. Stella came on board. My team was set. And the plan? Find Steve, find where he's hiding the gold, and then take it all from him. Easy, huh? But first we needed to get some wheels and fake IDs. Handsome Rob was all over it. He had the IDs waiting for us at Skinny Pete's golf range in the hills. So we had to get there and then rent the wheels. What could go wrong? Stella and I took a nice little ride. These look beautiful. Next, we had to try them out at the rental office. Sometimes Handsome Rob can be a little overconfident. Turns out the IDs weren't quite as perfect as we thought. Now we had the cops after us. Those cops just didn't want to be shaken. But then I didn't want to get caught. We finally had our rental car and things were ready to move. We suspected Steve would be sitting on all the gold in LA where he could watch it. But we had a little problem. Once we had it, how were we going to get it out of town? We needed fast cars. Cars that could cut through the LA traffic. Cars that could ride anywhere. We needed Mini Coopers. I sent Handsome Rob and Stella to pick up a pair.
Thank you.
Coopers worked out just fine. Too bad Rob and Stella brought them back totaled. Still, we learned the minis could do the job. Now all we needed were new ones. A good plan is all about the details. We had the right vehicles. The minis could carry the gold and run the sidewalks if we needed them to. But where was Steve's house, and where was the gold? Two big details. Lyle could track Steve. We just needed a van to hide the gear in. Handsome Rob scored the van, but then we had a surprise show up. Steve. No time like the present. Rob used the van to tail him. We'll be right back. handsome Rob lived up to his billing. He pulled off about as neat a tale as they come, straight back to Steve's house. Cross off another detail. Now, where the hell in that big joint was the gold? And how would we get it out? Now that we knew where Steve lived, Lyle got the van ready to do a little reconnaissance. And we also knew that the minis were the right wheels for the job. Only thing is, we needed three new ones after Rob and Stella's road test. The three of us would have to go after the new minis and hope the cops didn't mind too much. Stella made good on her pickup. One mini down, two to go. Handsome came through fine, not even a scratch this time. I had to get the last. I brought in the third, three Mini Coopers, all ready to roll. But they needed to shed a little weight before they could be used to carry all that gold. We left them in the company of Wrench, our hired mechanic, for a little custom work. We watched Steve's place, but nothing went in, and nothing came out. I knew what we had to do. Someone had to get inside. So Lyle blows Steve's cable, calls the service. We reroute the call and send in our own technician. But the fact that Steve knew all of us meant that our cable guy would have to be Stella. She didn't like the idea. Not at all. But there was no other option. Now all we needed was a cable van and uniform. Handsome Rob scored with a cable chick named Becky. We had our uniform and a van. Too bad he picked up some LA heat on the way back. Stella wasn't happy, especially when Steve hit on her. But she did get a look around, and she saw where the gold must be. Locked inside a Worthington 1000. Tough to crack, but not impossible. Supposedly. But to bust in, we needed Steve out. Now lucky Stella got to go out on a date with the guy who killed her father. Sometimes the price of revenge is too high. Handsome Rob did the run from Steve's to Union Station, where we would take the gold, over and over. His best time? 35 minutes top. Way too slow. Lyle said he could fix that. He just had to hack into the traffic control center and make sure that we got green all the way before Steve got back from his date. But first, Lyle needed his laptop. And then he could pay a little visit to the traffic center. We got moving. We'll be right back. Lyle hacked into the center in minutes. A few algorithms later, and the lights flashed green from Steve's all the way to the station. You've gotta hand it to him. The kid's a genius. Now we could ride like Rockefeller. We had the traffic system under control, but we had another problem, an electroplated fence rigged around Steve's mansion. Not to left ear. He had exactly the right boom in mind to blow a nice-sized hole in the fence. He just needed to pick up some supply of nitrum in from Skinny Pete. Left ear may know explosives, but the mini stick shift stopped him cold. Lyle drove left ear to his wheels. Trimmin. Left ear handled it with kid gloves on the ride back. Thank you. Stella showed up late for her date with Steve. He didn't mind or seemed to notice how nervous she was. Seeing her father's killer was a lot for her to deal with, but she dealt, and we went to Steve's mansion to hit the safe. We were almost there. There's one thing that can screw up great plans. The unexpected. Turns out Steve's neighbor was having a party. A big party. No way we were blowing our way into Steve's tonight. And Stella's date? That started going pretty badly when Steve figured out who the hot cable girl was. I had to get her out of there and fast, while Steve sent his goons after us. Stella's cover was blown. Steve knew we were all alive and after his gold. Then he made a mistake. From Lyle's phone tap, we knew Steve had decided to move the gold. It couldn't have been better. Now the gold was coming to us. Lyle picked up Steve's plan. A private chopper would pick up Steve while three armored trucks would pick up, guess what? The gold. Once he got the gold to the airport, Steve could go anywhere. He'd be gone. So we'd make sure that didn't happen. Lyle could cook up the worst traffic jam in LA history, then we'd boost the trucks. But what about Steve watching from the air? That part was easy. Get the truck to a place where Steve couldn't see. Under the street. Down to the LA Metro. Who says the subway isn't the way to go? Steve would be blind, and we'd have the gold. Now to test the whole thing out. We needed Stella to drive, and she had to be good. A little road test action was called for. Lyle shut down the Metro, while Rob and I set the pace.
Thank you.
Stella came through. Was there ever a doubt? Now we knew we had the time we needed, the perfect place, and the perfect getaway. It was, as they say, showtime. Three armored trucks, but only one could have the gold. Can't say Steve wasn't thinking. Good use of decoys. But as we tailed each truck, Lyle said he could tell us which one had the gold. All that weight would make it ride lower. You gotta love that nerd. Handsome Rob would have to tail each truck and find the right one. And Lyle would use the traffic lights to steer the truck and the gold to a nice little surprise that Left Ear prepared especially for Steve.
We'll be right back.
gotta admit, left ear noses booms. That truck fell right through the street and down to the metro below. The gold was right where we wanted it. A big plate covered the hole in the street, and just like that, Steve could see his truck was gone. Rob picked up Left Ear and followed me and Stella in our minis to the truck. They could take out the drivers and grab the gold before Steve even had a clue what happened. Hey, who says stress isn't fun? We got to the truck okay, but Steve had switched the safes, and this one was uncrackable. I told Stella she could do it, that she had to do it. She cracked it, and now we had 208 bricks of Indonesia's finest. But we also had some company. Steve's goons were right behind.
Thank you.
We made it out of the metro to the dam. But now, not only did we have Steve's guards on our tail, Steve himself had joined the chase. He wasn't about to give away the gold that easily. Stella insisted that she distract Steve's men while Rob and I went on, and as usual, there was no arguing with her. Rob and I lost our tail, but Steve and his goons were still sticking close to Stella. We had a train to catch, and sticking together made it too easy to be followed. So we split up and hoped that Stella could lose Steve's goons, because we weren't leaving without her. Stella did it, but Rob found himself settling an old score with the LAPD. Rob lost the cops. That guy really is as good as he says. Now I had to make sure I wasn't late for the party. We had the gold, the train was ready. But you know, there was one thing. I still had a score to settle. I was gonna take Steve down.
Thank you.
had the gold. The train was ready. I was gaining on Steve, but the cops joined in our little chase, and they were gaining on me. They set up roadblocks to pen us in. I saw the roadblocks in time. Steve didn't. Like I said, you've got to pay attention to details. Poor Steve. He was never any good at that. It was a beautiful sight, but I didn't have time to hang around. I was in a car full of gold, and I had a train to catch.